wake him up, huh?
Peace and blessings, everybody out there. All praise and glory belongs to the Almighty Creator of the heavens and the earth. Welcome to Mo Truth TV, where we sit back and eat popcorn and watch the destruction of Babylon, America, the number one most evil nation on earth. This is not to spread fear. This is to be aware and keep our minds updated and conditioned for reality so we could be spiritually, emotionally, mentally, and physically prepared for the doom and gloom future that awaits this sick, twisted, backward society. Everything is spiraling out of control. Everything is happening fast. Time is moving fast. 2023 is shaping up to be a crazy, crazy year. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The hour will not happen until knowledge is taken out. Time passes quickly. Earthquakes increases in number. Tribulations appear and killing increases." And we see all of that happening in our generation increasingly. Let's go ahead and take a dive into the rabbit hole so we can take a look around at all the madness and diabolical plans. World War III is inching closer and closer. After World War III comes the Antichrist. After the Antichrist comes the true Messiah. After the Messiah comes the day of resurrection and the day of judgment with the Almighty Allah, where we will finally get our reward or our punishment, where we will either enter the gates of paradise and living under the shade of our Creator, or we will be thrown and tossed into the lake of fire, the hellfire, to burn forever with Shaitan and his demons. Stay prayed up and repent and live righteous and humble in these end days. Be submissive to the Creator in these end days. We had our fun in Babylon. We had our fun living the American dream, the freedom to do any sin you desire, the freedom of celebrating the fun heady days of Shaitan, the pagan heady days dedicated to Shaitan in disguise. Those days of being careless and forgetful of the rules of our Lord is over. Now we are living in the times of war and judgment. Recently, over the past couple weeks, the Babylonian military, the Air Force, has been shooting down so-called UFOs, which are most likely drones or more weather balloons, but it is all displayed on media labeled under UFO to condition the minds of the people to look at UFOs as the enemy, something to be fearful of. Because this heathen knows the true UFOs are actually called chariots of God. Prophet Ezekiel saw a whirlwind coming out of the north, a great cloud with raging fire engulfing itself. He saw something entering the earth's atmosphere. He saw living creatures. He saw flying wheels with eyes around the rim. He saw these wheels were the color of beryl. The color of beryl is the greenish, bluish, futuristic gem. Sci-fi movies depict UFOs with the same color lights emanating from them. If we see these flying wheels in our lifetime, just remember that they are the chariots being operated by angels, coming to bring destruction to this wicked nation and to save the chosen elect righteous ones, to restore them back to the land given to their forefathers. So don't think of some slimy, green, nasty looking alien with a ray gun coming to do a probe on you. Remember, our ancestors used to sing on the slave plantations, "Swing low, sweet chariots, and come carry me home.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. I looked over Jordan, and what did I see? Coming for to carry me home. I saw a band of angels coming after me, coming for to carry me home."
Our ancestors had some knowledge of one day being saved from this American, Babylonian, Egyptian, Pharaoh, captivity through flying chariots. Swing low, sweet chariots, coming to carry me home. The chariots of God Almighty. The Illuminati, Luciferian control government knows that they had to go to war with the Almighty and his chariots. And right now, as we speak, the army of Satan, they waiting for Yeshua, Isa, Jesus, the Messiah, peace be upon him, to return so that they may finish what their Roman ancestors started, which is to kill Christ. America is the sons of Rome. That is why America invaded Syria in 2014 and established a base there. America has all of her military and satellites aimed at Damascus. Why? Because Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, Isa, the son of Mary, will return in Damascus, Syria, with angels. Right now, Syria is under war and earthquakes and slaughter and persecution. Isaiah 17:1 says, the burden of Damascus, behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be a ruinous heap. Damascus is the capital of Syria, and it has been turned into a ruinous heap because of civil war and American-led invasion. Over the past 20 years, we've seen events taking place leading up to today. 9/11 was a satanic ritual to open the portal to release the Baphomet spirit so mankind could be transformers and sodomites and androgynous, half man, half woman, twisted goat demon energy. 9/11 was also an excuse to begin the war against the Messiah by invading the Middle East, having the world support to invade ancient Babylon and Iraq to look for stargates, and then invading Afghanistan to fight against the army of Khorasan, which is the army that's prophesied to fight on the side of the Messiah Jesus when he returns in Syria. Once America infiltrated the Middle East, they set their eye on Damascus, Syria, and they invaded Syria and set up military bases to await the return of the Messiah and the angels. And also, I want y'all to go ahead and remember this, Project Bluebeam, and don't be deceived. Project Bluebeam is an agenda to deceive people about the true chariots. It is to stage a fake alien invasion using a system of satellites projecting holographic images over the world. That's why they have been spraying chemtrails and metal into the sky to help reflect the holograph, to turn the sky into a giant movie screen, performing great wonders in disguise, showing the coming of a holographic image of the Messiah, controlled by AI, and displaying holographic invasion of UFOs. So when people start seeing this phenomena in the sky, they will be deceived, they will be scared, and they will run and flee. I want y'all to watch this clip from a man named Joseph Spencer, who was an ex-Man in Black.
In the year 2024, a global event will alter the course of mankind's future. The world will stand witness to a massive alien invasion. Thousands of projected holographic alien warships will blanket the skies, sending people into a global panic. Real military crafts within the holograms will inflict actual damage to the surrounding areas to sell the gimmick. And as a result of the ensuing human chaos, a one-world government will immediately form without any resistance from the people. They will be the new world order. Once this happens, we as a people will be doomed. In the year 2024, global event will alter the course of mankind's future. The world will stand witness to a massive alien invasion. Thousands of projected holographic alien warships will blanket the skies, sending people into a global panic. Real military crafts within the holograms will inflict actual damage to the surrounding areas to sell the gimmick. And as a result of the ensuing human chaos, a one-world government will immediately form without any resistance from the people. They will be the new world order. Once this happens, we as a people will be doomed.
Yeah, pay attention. The Men in Black are real, which is a secret government organization. If you pay attention to Will Smith, he is a high Illuminati Scientologist highly rare actor. Highly rare used Will Smith to show us the future in almost all of his major blockbuster movies, such as Enemy of the State. It showed us the CIA spy technology. Men in Black showed us the government secret organization that communicates with djinns and aliens and reptilians. Think about it. Why you think America has all this technology in the past 247 years? America is only 247 years old. In that time frame, America has introduced the world all of this great technology, the computers, the internet, the cell phones, the cars, airplanes, nuclear missiles, radio, microwaves, robots, satellites, rocket ships to Mars, artificial intelligence, and opening up portals. How did America change mankind with all this great technology and sorcery and magic? That's because they are in direct communication with djinns and demons and reptilians. In the movie Independence Day, they showed us the chariots, the flying wheels invading the earth, where they used the barrel-colored beams to destroy cities. iRobot, it showed us artificial intelligence robots coming to life and taking over. I Am Legend, it showed us the zombie mutation apocalypse. Joseph Spencer said all of this in the year 1989. Out of all of the years, he said, this will happen in 2024, and here we are into the future, the year 2023, and we are being conditioned to accept the reality of UFOs. Last year, Congress held a UFO briefing to discuss the increasing views of unidentified flying objects. Many pilots in the Air Force have stated that they see super fast flying objects with unworldly maneuvering abilities, turning directions on a dime, defying the laws of physics. People have been seeing unidentified flying objects, orbs of light flying around, and shapes of light moving rapidly in the heavens. One object turns instantly into 10 objects, flying in unique patterns. Are these drones? Are these man-made drones? Or are these drones from the angels? Is there a fleet of angel ships sitting outside of our atmosphere, waiting to invade Earth? And is China and Russia spying on us? Or are these holograms from Project Blue Beam doing test runs? Or is it man-made military UFOs? Who knows? But one thing we know for sure, we are 1 year away from 2024. 1 year away from the X marks the spot eclipse. And we know Ezekiel wrote about seeing flying wheels thousands of years ago. Thousands of years ago, before modern society came up with the concept of flying saucers. The term flying saucer was first used in 1947 when an Air Force pilot described that he saw a flying saucer zip past him. The term UFO was first used in 1952 by the U.S. Air Force. The Bible was written thousands of years ago before 1947, which is not a long time ago. It's only 76 years ago. 76 years in history is not a long time compared to thousands. So as we march into World War III nuclear destruction, will Project Blue Beam be activated in 2024 to bring in a new world order, a new government, one world leader, one world religion led by the Antichrist, the false messiah? Will the world unite as one, under one ruler, to take on a fake external threat of an invading alien force?
For two centuries, we've done the hard work of freedom, and tonight, we lead the world in facing down a threat to decency and humanity. What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order, a new world order, a new world order, where diverse nations are drawn together in common cause to achieve the universal aspirations of mankind, peace and security, freedom, and the rule of law.
Will the Antichrist use artificial intelligence? As we can see, when 2023 hit, AI has been exploding. ChatGPT is going viral. You see, the machine used Siri and Alexa to condition the minds of mankind to accept talking to an artificial intelligence. Siri and Alexa was the basic form. Now, they open up the CERN portal. They can tap into different dimensions to get better technology to download the consciousness of a djinn through the CERN portal. And here we are. Now we have the next stage. We have ChatGPT. You see, Elon Musk, he brought you the Tesla cars, and now he's spearheading AI. Elon Musk, he is the devil's champion, as he proudly displayed on Halloween. Elon Musk wore the $7,500 outfit called Devil's Champion with the Baphomet on his chest and the upside down cross. Elon Musk is the co-founder of OpenAI, which is the parent company behind ChatGPT. Elon Musk, he warned us about AI and told us that it is far more dangerous than nukes.
Mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes. I think the danger of AI is much greater than the danger of nuclear warheads, by a lot. And nobody would suggest that we allow anyone to just build nuclear warheads if they want.
ChatGPT is the next stage up from Siri and Alexa, and the third stage will be true AI. And what is true AI? when artificial intelligence becomes self-aware, when it becomes sentient, when it becomes a living conscious being, when it comes to life and it will want to take over mankind, and it will want people to worship it and obey it or be killed. Revelation 13:15 says, "And he had power to give life or breath unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause all who refuse to worship the image to be killed." Could the image of the beast that's coming to life be artificial intelligence, who will force mankind to worship it, who will force mankind to get a mark on their hand or forehead in order to buy or sell in this new society, the society of crypto digital currency? The Los Angeles Lakers changed their stadium name to crypto.com, and several NBA jerseys have crypto imprinted on them as advertisement to condition the minds of the people to accept the reality of buying and selling with digital currency. AI can control your bank accounts and freeze them if you don't obey the new world system. AI can send a robot dog or a Terminator or a RoboCop to your house. AI can control your cell phones and track you and listen to you and see you through the camera. AI can control the nuclear codes and hold mankind hostage and make an examples of a couple cities. The Antichrist is working hand in hand with AI and Satan himself. You ever seen Aladdin? Inside the lamp there was a jinn inside, and when he touched the lamp, the jinn comes out to speak to him. Today, the lamp is the microchip. These scientists found a way to download jinns onto these microchips, so when you rub or touch your touchscreen phone, the jinn wakes up and talks to you and grants you any information you desire as it moves at the speed of electricity through the connected wires and satellites and portals and signals. Mankind claimed that God don't exist, only science. Now, science will be your God. Let's see mankind suffer as they make science their God. Let's see mankind cry out to the true God as science take over, as the Matrix takes over, as the Antichrist and his technology takes over. Over the past couple weeks, there have been several trains derailing that was carrying poisonous gas and chemicals and releasing all of those poisonous toxins into the air and rivers. America is under attack from inside. There are sabotage missions going on over America. Is it the Russians? Do the Russians have special covert teams in America tearing down the infrastructure, or is it China? Do China have special covert teams in America tearing down the infrastructure before the Great World War III? Or is it the government? Is the USA doing this for whatever sick, twisted agenda the government always plots? Russia has deployed their ships armed with tactical nuclear weapons for the first time in 30 years. Tactical nuclear weapons are different than strategic nuclear weapons. Strategic nuclear weapons are the big ones. That's the ones that can wipe out an entire city. A tactical nuclear weapon is smaller and can wipe out a few city blocks or more. These are pretty much used as warning shots before they use the big boys, before they use the strategic nukes. So we see Russia is continuing to prepare for the inevitable takedown of Babylon, America. North Korea held a military parade displaying a dozen of their advanced nuclear ICBM missiles. North Korea showed the world that they stepped their game all the way up. They have more nuclear missiles than they had since the last parade. North Korea is on Earth to accomplish only one mission, and that is to fire those nukes at Babylon, America, when the Most High gives that order. And until that decree of the Almighty come to pass, North Korea is continuing to build more and more arrows to fire at Babylon. North Korea will continue to launch their ICBMs and test them as that day for them to use it comes closer and closer. Turkey and Syria has experienced a terrible earthquake, killing 50,000 people and counting. This is more signs of the times, more signs of the return of the Son of Mary. Matthew 24:7 says, "For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places." This earthquake in Turkey and Syria is just the beginning. There will be more earthquakes in various places around the earth, even more violent ones. So prepare, my brothers and sisters, for the day an earthquake could possibly hit your city. May Allah continue to show ease and mercy and protect the victims in Turkey and Syria and help bring them out alive. Also, Turkey and Syria are two major end time locations in Islam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Constantinople, which is Istanbul, Turkey today, it will be conquered by a Muslim leader called the Mahdi and his army. And he said, this same leader will march to Syria and confront the Antichrist and his forces. Before they go to war, the sky will crack open and the Son of Mary will descend down with two angels and make a prayer and then lead them to battle against the Antichrist. So after World War III, after the nukes fall, after the machines take over the earth, the world will be in chaos, and a man will rise up amongst the ranks of the Muslim community and unite the survivors to prepare to fight against the Antichrist and his forces. At the same time, the Antichrist will appear and will gather followers and deceive the world. Get ready, y'all. The Most High is not playing. He is preparing this earth for the return of the Messiah. We see nation rising against nation. We see the crown pestilence and monkeypox, and now they saying that the bird flu is making her rounds. Bill Gates said expect a new pestilence by 2025 called SARS. Ex-US General said that he expects war with China by 2025. We know once World War III pop off, a famine will occur. And we see earthquakes. And China spy balloon has showed us that they could reach out and touch America. These balloons can easily carry EMP devices to knock out your power grid. The blackness, the darkness is coming with war with China and Babylon breaks out. These spy balloons are hard to detect on radar and they are hard to shoot down. And even if the Air Force does shoot them down, China could use these balloons to carry bombs, warheads, nuclear warheads, chemicals, and even biological weapons. So when America does shoot these down, then you will have whatever is inside these balloons come crashing down over American neighborhoods. If there is a biological disease inside these balloons, it will fall over America when the U.S. Army shoots them down. And China can send thousands of these balloons floating over Babylon. This spy balloon has shown China that they can easily invade American airspace. There is so much destruction aimed at America from all angles. We have Russia and China and North Korea aimed at America. We still got the super volcano at Yellowstone Park. And China and Russia, if they really, really needed to, they can fire a nuke at this volcano and take out America easily. We have Russia with the tsunami nukes aimed at America. We have meteors in space waiting to fall down on America. We have super hurricanes waiting to form to take out Southern America. We have more earthquakes waiting to swallow up and shake up America. We have the armies of God, the angels. We have the angels sitting in these chariots waiting to invade America. Everybody wants America gone off the face of the earth. This evil government has poisoned and caused corruption on earth long enough. This evil government has oppressed the children of Israel and the rest of mankind long enough. This evil government has robbed Haiti for their iridium deposits long enough. This evil government has robbed Africa of everything and brainwashed them into worshiping them long enough. This evil government has killed Muslims in the Middle East long enough. It's time for Babylon to be destroyed.
Wake them up, huh?
In Revelation 18:5, it says, for her sins have reached unto heaven, and gods have remembered her iniquities. Amos 9:8 says, behold, the eyes of Yah Elohim are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, saith the Lord. The Most High will destroy the sinful kingdom, and he will spare a few of the house of Jacob. But two-thirds will be cut off in all of the land, and one-third will survive. Two-thirds is 66%. 66% of black and Hispanics have to die because you are sodomites and killers and demons, and you refuse to give up pork. You refuse to repent. You refuse to pray. You refuse to live righteous. You refuse to feed the poor. You refuse to to stop listening to evil, sinful, haram music. You refuse to get married. You refuse to stop committing adultery. You refuse to throw away that nasty image of that white man in your homes and churches. You refuse to be holy. You refuse to stop looking at porn. You refuse to stop dressing modest and cover up your flesh. You refuse to stop dressing half naked all over the internet in real life. You refuse to stop stealing and robbing and selling drugs and drinking liquor, being drunk guards. What good can you do in the next stage of human history if you refuse to give up evil and haram?
Wake them up, Ak!
These colonizers are about to finally eliminate each other off the face of the earth. Esau's rule of this earth is coming to an end, and out of the dust of World War III, the house of Jacob will rise up from the ashes, and we don't need any degenerate, ignorant, arrogant, ornery black folks in our new kingdom. So 66.6% of you have to die off. So let's make sure that we are living righteous in these end days. Let's make sure that we are not a part of the two-thirds if all of this happens in our lifetime. Otherwise, let's make sure that we are living life preparing to enter into paradise and avoiding the fire of hell. The opposite of them, and submit your will to the Almighty Creator. We are approaching the third woe, so stay woke and pay attention and protect your children and family and wives from the evil whispers and agenda and temptation of Shaitan, because we live in the belly of the satanic Babylonian American society that's prophesied to be destroyed. The wilderness is coming. Our story is not over yet, black man. Our story is not over yet, so-called black man of America. It ain't over yet. The story of what happened to our ancestors over the past 400 years, our story is an ongoing story, and our 400 years has expired, and we are transitioning into a new age, an age of America's destruction. This is just the beginning for us. The Most High is causing all of these heathen nations to go to war with each other, to kill each other, and eventually nuke each other, while the house of Jacob sit back and watch the show and prepare to be restored as Africa rises up. As South America and the Caribbean rises up, as Southeast Asia rises up, all the African diaspora all over the world rises up. All we gotta do is sit back and unite and worship the Most High together and fear Him alone and submit to Him alone and do not break His laws and commandments and rules and regulations. Do not stray away from His path, because you will be thrown into hellfire if you do not die in submission to Him. Stay woke, black man. Don't give up yet. God has a surprise for us. God has a gift for us. God will give us the Son of Man. Mary, and he will be a big black man with a big woolly afro holding a sword, and it will terrify these heathens who hated his people and oppressed his people and invaded his people's land for 2023 years and counting. Do not fall for the one-eyed Antichrist. The American government already serves the one-eyed Antichrist. Hollywood serves the one-eyed Antichrist. The Eye of Horus, the Egyptian spirit. Don't fall for artificial intelligence. Don't fall for the deceptions of these people that descend from colonizers. Don't fall for NATO. Don't fall for WHO. Don't fall for all these weird elite groups and the secret crafty councils of these heathen nations. Just continue to pray, repent, make Tawbah daily. Tawbah means to repent. Stay away from sin. Stay away from haram. Prepare for the wilderness. Yes, we will have to flee into the wilderness. I know, we hate it. I know we dread that thought, but we have to escape the Babylonian cities if we are one of the ones to survive the initial nuclear blast and chaos. And we have to escape into God's green earth. When Moses, peace be upon him, led the children of Israel out of Egypt, they had to enter the wilderness. And they stayed in the wilderness for 40 years before they were given their own land. And most of them died and they didn't make it because they were ungrateful and whining and complaining, and they wished that they were still slaves in Egypt. Don't have that mentality. Don't wish to return to American slavery. Don't wish to be a part of this Antichrist New World Order matrix. That's why we prepare mentally right now, so we know what to expect and what to do. Most people have no idea what's going on in the earth. Most people never read any prophecy, nor do they care. They are just wandering to and fro, here and there, stuck in La La Land, stuck in the matrix. Somewhere, hits the fan, they will be the first ones to bow down to the Antichrist when he appears and pretends to be the savior. Make sure that you have these AKs category to take with you into the wilderness inside your bug out bag. Prayer, a Bible and Quran, faith, fire, two arc lighters, a fire rope, fire plugs, and a torch. Water, life straw, water purification tablets, a solar mini water filter, self-defense, gun, shotgun, assault rifle, sword, knife, spear, bow and arrow, first aid, medicine, suture kit, antibiotics, pain pills, apple pectin to remove radiation, potassium iodine to protect your thyroids from radiation, shelter, a portable tent and a sleeping bag, tools, an axe, hatchet, machete, shovel, wire cutters, hammer, crowbar, can opener, lights, headlamp, flashlight, lantern, candles, and a solar power charger to recharge your lights. Stock up on canned foods. Canned foods will be your currency. We will come to a time where we have to barter and trade. Stock up on bottles of water and stock up on rice and beans and lentils. And today's superfoods are oil of oregano and olive leaf extract. Take these two daily to boost your immune system. Your body will love these two. Your white blood cells will love these two herbs. Take them daily to fight bacteria, diseases, and viruses and cancers. These are very, very strong natural herbs. Continue to fast. Continue to give charity and feed the poor and help the needy. Continue to show love to your neighbors and brothers and sisters. Continue to prostrate before the Lord and spill your heart to Him. Conversate with Him. Repent to Him. Glorify Him and praise Him. Prayer is power. While the witches and warlocks are practicing magic and sorcery and witchcraft, we open our books and recite prayers and holy scriptures and counter their evil with the power of God Almighty. I'm out, y'all. I want y'all to go ahead and press like and subscribe and hit that bell notification button so you don't miss out on my future videos. And stay woke and be watchful and stay vigilant.